Hello, my name is Julie.
Hello, Julie.
Hello.
I am 77 past. 2 years past. And I am single. Ready to mingle. But perhaps not with you. Or you? Who knows? How long have you been in Toastmasters? I know that some of you will just join soon, and others have been a lot longer than me. But I joined first time when I was 44 years old. Do you remember where and why you got to your first meeting?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. And how it felt? Really, first time I joined in Washington, D.C., because that time also I was single, and I wanted to find a man. I am still looking at Toastmasters, at least. Now, our workshop is called today Funny Bones. And when I made the title, I didn't realize that many people who are not from America or UK, like I am now from London, don't know that funny bones means being funny. Until I was 77 years old, yeah, 4 years ago, I didn't believe I was funny. I didn't believe I can make people laugh. And then I went to a Toastmaster contest in a club, in a band. And what happened? That the man, banker, who was a contestant, stripped. Oh! His pants fall down. His t-shirt went away, and people begin to laugh. And under it was a first jogging suit. He spoke about how Toastmaster and jogging is alike. So the next time I spoke about how I changed profession on a storytelling event, and I tell myself, I tried it. And I stripped too. I took out my t-shirt, like now. And of course, under the chemist one, which was my first profession, there was Apple, because my second was in computer business. But what happened? That people begin to laugh. And they begin to laugh, and all the 7 or 9 minutes I finished, they laughed at almost every silly thing I told, or serious things. So it worked. But I had a huge problem then. I didn't know why it worked. So I decided to study comedy. And at the age of 77, I discovered something which is called stand-up comedy. They have very good books about stand-up comedy and workshops, and as I get once. Very well paid for storytelling from this grand whiskey. I put all my money, like our keynote speaker told, and all my time to take workshops and to learn about comedy and how to make people laugh when I want. Not by chance. And after many times I succeeded. Now, at the first workshop, I tried to tell there was a child inside me lurking, and they looked at me. It didn't work. And the second time at the same workshop, I came with my cane and I didn't have my leg broke at that time yet, like now. And almost, can you take it? Almost fall and told them, I am 77 years old. Stand-up comedian at this age? What the heck I am doing here? So I told him some four-letter words, which I don't tell you now, but all laughed. And then I told them what really happened that morning. And my daughter called all the way from Washington and told me, Mommy, I read your text. I sent to her to correct. You cannot use those words. Not you. But she's not here. So I begin that to explain you how comedy can work and how you can use it. And what I learned, at least at first workshop, please come in and sit down in front. Not back, in front. And if you can stay there, because you are the only one staying there. Can you sit in the middle? Yeah, thank you. So, first of all, you have to acknowledge what you are, how people look at you, how people see how you are, with their stereotyping and everything. And then second, not tell them, but prove them, then you have something more in you. Not only what they see. Things they can find anyway on internet, eventually. And finally, build a bridge between you and audience. What is similar to me and you? I am old, you are young, I am from Hungary or France or London, you are from Finland, from Sweden, from Africa or Germany. But what is the same? We all have the similar experience that someone was not there and we wanted to do something. True? Mm-hmm. Yes. With our parents or friends or who knows whom. So there are some things which are deep inside, which are similar, which brings all of us together. Now, first time I would like you together by countries and speak together 3 minutes together in group. What is the humor in your country? In England, humor that works very well is when you mock yourself. When you mock the group you are from. It goes very well with audience. In France, what goes well is usually you mock authorities and how you defy them. That will never go well in America, where people are proud that I never had a parking ticket, they told me once. So I would like to know first, each group, and please gather fast because we have only a few minutes. Decide, and one of the group will tell us what is characterizing the humor of the country you live.
Okay.
Okay.
So you move a little bit. There is a timekeeper for 3 minutes. Hello, hello. It is finished. Please go to your place. And now please, all those chosen from different things come in, come out here. Those who you had chosen to speak. come here, one near other, because we speak fast. Other groups who will speak? Yeah. Okay. So everyone is here. I will give you the mic and try short, because we cannot stay more, unhappily.
One to maximum 1.5 minutes, possible. Tell what is your country and what is the specific of humor in your country.
Hello, and my name is Evelyn, and I'm from Finland.
Hello, Evelyn.
Hi, we love at we have jokes about Swedish people, and the Finns are always the best. And then of course we joke about drinking and being drunk and then having the hangover and maybe some, I don't know, fart jokes and stuff like that. So.
Hello, my name is Kai, and we had a huge German fraction in this group, so it was difficult to coordinate everything. But we finally came up with the answer that probably we have a lot of very low-level humor, but at the same time we have also a lot of political stand-up. And in general maybe a lot of playing with clichés, I think that's maybe something which I would put out.
Hi, I'm Pradeep, actually originally from India, but now in Latvia, so for the last 25 years, so, but I will tell you about India. We joke about politicians a lot, and we have, if you know, the people who have trouble.
Yeah.
These are called Sikhs, Sardarji.
Yeah.
So we have a lot of jokes about them. Why? Because they have long hair, and in the daytime, India is a hot country. When 12 o'clock, the sun is very hot, and they have long hair, and that they start something stupid things. They say, oh, 12 o'clock, I think.
I'm Estonian, so Estonian humor is very sarcastic. It's black humor, it's irony, so we like a lot of British humor. We connect with it very well. And of course, something very unique, we make fun of our neighbors.
Hello, my name is Kate, I'm from Latvia, but I'm going to speak about Russian humor because in our group there was one Ukrainian girl, but a Russian girl. I'm from Latvia, but my native language is Russian.
Speak a little bit nearer.
Yes, so we didn't come up with any jokes, any specific jokes, but in general we make fun of our people, Russian people. It comes from literature, I guess. Our humor is aimed at making jokes about our people, so we don't joke about people around, we joke only about ourselves. I think this is something very, very specific about ourselves.
And I'm from Latvia. Well, Latvians love to joke about current events, for example, what politicians said wrong in English. Another thing is that we like to joke about our neighbors. And we have a saying that the tastiest food for Latvia is another Latvian.
The same in Estonia.
The same, right?
Yeah, we also say from Estonia.
It's very unique, I can say.
Hello, my name is Lena, I'm from Sweden. We had two Norwegian guys in our group and the four Swedish, and we agreed that the Swedish humor is not to blend out. Because we have Luther on one shoulder and Jante on the other one, and Jante says, don't think you are something special, don't think you are better than anyone else. Mm-hmm. So it's quite a lot of irony, a lot of black humor, and we connect easily with British humor, you can say, in general.
So good morning, I'm Greta from Lithuania. And yeah, and we have been talking that actually we're joking about each other a lot, and even our common example within the group that some of us are the youngest ones, some of us are the oldest ones, and then we're joking a lot about each other, so that irony that you have mentioned before. Also, of course, about the neighbors and about the minorities in Lithuania. And then we have very strong jokes about the cities inside Lithuania. Let's say Vilnius is the capital, and then we're joking about Kaunas. And Kaunas probably not joking about Vilnius. That's what I'm saying. Funny, and besides, ladies don't use this kind of words. I understood, I am not funny. And for 70 more years I believed it. It took me 70 more years to get the courage to learn to use my funny bones. Because we are all inside us, we just have to use it. There is not one who has never been and will never be funny. So it depends on you to decide. Now, let's see what works when you go to Prague. What works in America at the big contest? What works in corporations? I have to tell you that humor is very useful. My father was a businessman, and he held very serious, tough commercial discussion between other countries, what to buy, what to sell, and so on. And the temperature ran high, and people wanted to go away. He told a joke. And the joke changed the mood. So the joke opened hearts. I will tell you at the end, the joke is good to other things too, to yourself. But the joke is very good to open hearts of people to listen to you. And then you tell stories. You will hear next about storytelling. I am also a storyteller, and I don't like to be put in a box. You can look at my links. I have a blog. When I got my Competent Communicator Award, I decided I will open a blog about speaking, public speaking, and I was extremely I didn't understand how no one used the name competentcommunicator.blogspot in Google. So it is mine. It is easy to remember. And I have links there for all the books I recommend and all the speeches you can look at and all the words I don't tell you here. So now, I told you I went to many workshops, one after other, and I told myself I am too old to go out at night until I go to Dave Jones with the Toastmaster in September of my 77 year, 2012, excuse me. So he's a champion of table topics in London, in England, Ireland also. Now, yesterday, no, it's 16, before yesterday, he got the fifth time was table topic champion. But he's also a very good teacher. And he told us, if you don't go out,
in the club 20 times, you don't come to my class. So I decided that I will sleep afternoon, and then I can go out at the night. And after you go to your first club, and to your second club, and then you decided, no, so what? I'll try something new. I went to 20, after 20 I couldn't stop. And I decided I begin at 77, I will count until 77. And now it is long past 77, but I don't count anymore. And then I tell people, and women lies even more, I am a comedy virgin. Yeah, but only of comedy. Man, I stop at counting after three. So you don't have to tell swear words in order to put things in people's minds. I'll give you an example. And I have to tell you, I thought a lot about it because I was very angry at first. Someone brought me on Facebook, who had been on my stand-up comedy, I would like to be your toy boy. What? I went back to Wikipedia, I never heard about it. Anyway, I don't like boys. I like men. And toys? I have in my drawer. Near my bed, I have something even more important, because size matters. And my best tools is always near my hand, near my bed. My best tool is a Kindle. And of course I had a cataract operation, and at that time I couldn't have eyeglasses, and it was very important to have a size, a big size of characters. And read. And after 9 long months, I had eyeglasses. So, what I do now? I have 5 grandchildren. And so I decided to put on this Kindle, because it is well hidden, 50 shades of gray. All big volumes, which my grandchildren cannot see. So that was just an example of how you can tell about yourself without using any words, reveal something, and make laugh about yourself. And of what it was not in my, I didn't tell you, it was in your mind, some of the things which you imagined that I told. Now, I went after the third workshop to another, with someone who is called Igor Tembina, who is a very old Jewish stand-up comedian, philosopher in my opinion. He showed us something, which I try with you now. He told us you have to reveal something deep, but that is told. But then he showed us. So when I tell about myself, I am old, okay. You can see it anyway. When I tell that I am Toastmaster, and I have been Toastmaster for so long, or single, you go to Facebook, you can see it. But no one of you will see all the things I told you now, which you laughed when I told. So now I would like you to have some volunteers, 3 of you, who will tell me, it doesn't have to be funny at all. One thing that everyone can see when looks at her or him, the second that can be found on Facebook or through friends. And third, reveal something deeper. Okay? And then you will tell me later which one interested you more, which one he or she told us. Do you understand? Okay, let's try. Yeah.
Good morning, everyone. Can you hear me well?
Yes.
So, one thing that is pretty obvious about me is that I am a bit on the short side. The thing that you can find about me, that I spent this summer half a year in South America. You can find that on Facebook. And one thing a bit deeper, something that not everyone knows, my closest friends know about it, but I'm pretty sure majority here don't. I am a certified bartender and I love making cocktails.
Hello, good morning. My name is Robertas, and as you see, I have a long hair. Yeah. And you know, mostly I work with computers. And as you see my hair and hair too, sometimes it's told that when a man goes to computer and works, he sits here so long that the hair grows very long. Hello, my name is Andrus.
Okay.
as you see, my eyeglasses is very
thick.
My, I can't see very good without glasses. what can you see, find out from my Facebook? That I am interested in beautiful women.
The power of the ring.
And if I wear a ring, so you can think that I'm married. But without a ring, you couldn't find out.
No one knows. Tell us something new. Damn it.
My English is very.
Something deep.
I don't know many English words. Please repeat your question.
Something secret.
Something secret.
Yeah. Yeah. Deep. Knows. That nobody knows.
Yeah. Only yeah. One or two people here.
Yeah. I'm a Superman.
When I get a friend request from Toastmasters club members, I always check his or her status.
Have you heard how people laughed when he told that truth?
Yes.
That worked.
And you will see on Facebook that I like traveling. And with my wife, before fiance, we traveled to different countries and to look around more. And then, with children, small children, it's better to go to a big hotel when it's all included. All included, drinks, everything and so on. And in that moment, particular moment, I got out my alcohol drinking, became vegetarian, and went to this All included hotel.
Something even deeper?
Yeah, some people don't even speak, your friends don't know about it. It is not easy. I stayed 3 months with something I found, which is my ending in my stand-up comedy, until I dared to tell. And then I had seen that every time I tell it, people laugh and laugh and laugh. But you have to dare to open up. So you dare something or something?
Just a minute. I must admit, I'm drawing total blank right now.
So, what I tell towards the end of my stand-up comedy, when I do it, that stand-up comedy, okay, so I don't mind anymore about shaving, and I have a whole long story about shaving. Yeah, let's begin there. We women are very privileged than men, because we don't have to shave. True?
No.
But it's like pixies. It comes here and here and here, and you try everything out, doesn't work. So finally, I found a way to do it. With this. It works. So and so. But I found a better way. I photoshopped it out. And it never came back. So now I am out of the closet. As someone told about vegetarians yesterday. And I was still afraid a little bit of stand-up comedy until I found out that it's just like making love. And I know something about making love. So you have to pace yourself and not rush to the end. And of course you have to go back on the horse when you fail. And not remain there. And most important, you have it both to practice, and never give up, even after 70. Now, I'm a little bit out of practice now.
With stand-up.
But one day, I do it again. And then I tell not you, like I told at the beginning. And at the end, I don't mind even a one-night stand. If I am welcome that warm and you welcome me here now, don't call me in the morning, Google me. So, I don't use do it, I do use F word, which works even better, but it is true that I thought about it long time because I had the courage to begin to speak about it. And I will tell you now something more important. A very sad story. When I arrived in London, the oculist, I wanted to change my eyeglasses, told me, Julie, you have cataract. What? Yeah. But the hospital will not take you now. It is not bad enough. It has to be bad enough. Yeah. In England, it has. Now, 2 years later, it was so bad, I couldn't read in the bus the number. So then I went back, and they told me, yeah, now We can do it next week, but you have to sign. You don't sue us if you become blind. What? So I believe it's serious. And my son went with me to the hospital 7 o'clock in the morning, and by 9:30 I was home. They told me I have to, if I my head, I have big headaches, I take something, a pill, and every 3 minutes I have to put drops in my eyes. But then my son told me, Mommy, bye-bye, today we move, our family. What? I remained alone. I live alone, but I never ever felt so utterly alone than at that time. I went to sleep, and 2 hours later I woke up with a big headache, and I knew I had to put new drops in my eyes, and somehow I took my eyeglass to read how to use it. It was written, take a mirror, open your eyes, and put the drop. I didn't have 3 hands. And then I felt like a lost child. I never felt so alone and so sorry of myself. No friends around, no family around. I tried, without mirror. Forget the mirror. I will feel it if the drop comes. And so I put the drop, I tried. It didn't come. And I tried again. It didn't come. After 3 times, power of 3, of course, I looked at the bottle. The cup was on. It was not open. Now, suddenly, something new came to me. I can use that. I will be able to make people laugh with it, tell a story about it. And I realized I developed comedian eyes. Forget the cataract. Forget my bones, funny or not. Now I could look what happened to me with comedian eyes. And from then on, everything which happened to me was lighter. And that is why it is really worth to do and to learn humor, because then everyone, if you permit me, shit happens. Everyone has problems. And when the problem arrives, you begin to try to think, how can I speak about it? So, a year ago, I fall down in home, alone, again, and I fractured my leg and my ankle in 5 places. And I went to hospital, and I waited and waited and waited, and finally I go to someone who put the, what is called?
Plaster.
And I told the doctor, you know, I'm stand-up comedian. Yeah, you? And I think when the division governor election came, I was named division governor that time, too many people told me, break a leg. And it's hard to say in English. And my dumb Hungarian leg took it literally. Now, believe me, the doctor looked with the new eyes on me, and I was not supposed to remain in the hospital, and he found me a bed and put me there for a week. Because I could laugh of myself. So it is really worse. Whether you do it for business or for a competition or whatever, you can do it. I think 1 hour is there.
40 minutes.
We have more time?
Yes, about 10.
Okay. So now if we have more time, you can ask me questions. And I will answer you.
What do you do if someone steals your
thunder?
What do you do if someone steals your thunder? Do you know what that means?
No.
To steal your thunder. If you are about to tell a joke, and then someone in the audience heckles or
heckles.
Says the punchline.
I had to a special hacker line. It was my 75 gig. And I told myself I have a lot of table topics experience. Because believe me, all we learn in Toastmaster can be very well used. And I will begin to tell jokes and so on, and someone told me, oh, Julie, you are sure you had hundreds of men. And I looked at him and told him, I don't know, I stopped counting after three. And everyone laughed. I didn't put him down.
Yeah.
So I didn't have many hacking, but I take them nicely and try to tell something which seems instantaneous, but it's from my prepared set somewhere. Because I have now almost 15 minutes and I usually give only 7 or 10. So I have something. Now, what you do in stand-up comedy that is extremely useful to everyone is you put your best thing at the end and the second best in the beginning, and in the middle, you try out new things. And it is, I don't know if I told you, it is like trying out a new partner. You don't throw it out the first time. But if the 3 times doesn't work, you have to get rid. Because if not, all your life will be poisonous. So you have to try it again and again, and also know that all audience is not the same. But if you go with something deep, it resonates. Because inside us, we all want to be loved. We all want partners. We all want different things or fear some things. And that is human nature. So if you find something, it is not about you. People don't care about you, perhaps at all. But it resonates with something inside you or you or you. Then they laugh. And also, of course, you learn with time that they have to be near you, they possibly in the dark. And if possible, to have someone who laughs very strongly in the front. And then, okay. And if not, you have a few laughs. So what? They don't have to laugh at every joke you tried out. Now, I don't tell jokes and stories until it is something I want to say. So what do you think I want to say? I want to say that all people are not like some preconceptions, and that I say it without telling, showing it. Yeah. And that you also can do it, not only me. So you go away telling, if she can do it, I can do it also. And that works. And I have some other things about husbands and cheating. If you go to my material, you will see it. Anyway, other questions? Yes?
How do you act if you tell a joke where you're supposed to get a lot of laughter and it's completely silent in the room?
Nothing, you go further. You just say to yourself, that joke here didn't work. And then you try out eventually another place. I had some jokes about, I don't mind telling four letter words in English, but never in my mother language, Hungarian. And that, like, some people from Spain and so on liked it, but English didn't. So I just put it out from my jokes. You wait a little bit to see if they laugh or not, but not too long. And don't make any special thing. They don't even know that it's supposed to be a joke. And when you tell a story, it is a joke if people laugh. If it doesn't, it is not a joke. And you go further. That's all. It is not a tragedy. And sometimes they do laugh at things you never believe. I never believe people will laugh when I tell I photoshopped a dog. Every time, or I went to Wikipedia, every time I tell anything about multimedia, because I am old, so use what you don't have. Use your handicaps, because it works. Yes?
Yeah. So you mentioned that you take your life, everyday events in your life, and then you uncover humor in it. So do you have any more practical tips how we can do that with what's happening in our life, how to find that funny angle?
It takes time. And experience. Okay? So 4 years, I know did that for 4 years. And in the beginning, as I told you, when someone wrote me about Toy Boy, I just was angry. And I waited almost 6 months until I found what to tell about it. And then later, how to link it to my cataract and so on, and make laugh even more. But toying with the idea, asking yourself how I can use that bad thing which happened, it can be very bad or a little bit frustrating only. You toy with it, you think about it day and night, and something will come out. Other things you can do list of 100 things, 100 ideas, and from 100, one or two could be good, and you can try them out. There are different ways of doing it. What I suggest, don't take something which is too much, too heavy, and too near you, so you don't feel too bad about it. It took me, my husband cheated on, my first husband cheated on me, and it took me many, many years to try to tell a story about it and to joke about it. But now I can tell you that I use it. My children hate it. But I make laugh every time, and my past change. That means I look at it now back with a smile instead of heartache. But with my leg, it came 3 hours later, I broke my leg. But depends what it is, this time it will come. Try it. And I hope at least everyone goes away from that, trying to do, and telling yourself, yes, you can develop comedian eyes, and yes, I can be funny. If she can do it, I can do it.